Look, Osborne, I've called you in today because you aren't meeting your work quota. You used to be my star employee. What happened?
I'm sorry, Mr. Baldwin. I've just been feeling a bit off my game lately.
You know how I feel about excuses.
I know. It's just, I haven't been able to shake this feeling that I'll be doing the same thing for the rest of my life.
You work a corporate job. You're paid to do the same thing every day. Know that that's for the rest of your life, that's your decision. But you need to pay attention to how you work the next couple weeks. Because if you keep missing deadlines, I'll have no choice but to fire you. And you know I really don't want it to come to that.
Yeah, I know. It's just... Again, I'm sorry. It's just something's gonna have to change.
Stop. You're a part of my company, which has been passed down for 3 generations. My father, well, he was a ruthless man. He'd do anything to make the company successful, and if that meant dealing with dangerous men or ending close friendships, he'd do it. So listen to me on this. Make your next deadline. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now go enjoy the rest of your day off. Maybe the last one you get for a while. Good day, Mr. Osborne.
Drink.
You look a bit too established to be in a place like this.
What? Oh. Yeah, sorry. I just got a lot on my mind right now.
Lose your job? Friend passed away? Late trouble?
I don't feel comfortable talking about it to someone I just met.
Okay. I get that. My name's Giada. Giada Biancardi.
My name's Mark.
Got a last name?
Osborne.
Mark Osborne. Sounds familiar.
I have no clue why. Just work a dull job out of the offices downtown.
We're at
Baldwin Corp.
Have you ever tried this cocktail? It's a mix between Larceny Bourbon and Averna Maro. Where's the soul? In the stomach.
Maybe I'll have to give it a try. Bartender.
Yeah, and to think I was worried about losing my job.
Lose your job? Why is that?
I've just been feeling empty, you know? Like, I don't have a purpose. Everything the same, day after day. It gets old. My boss, Mr. Baldwin, talks to me about how I haven't been myself, and I've been falling behind at work. He just doesn't understand.
Sounds like you're going through a hard time. You know, I might know a guy who could help you out.
Oh yeah? And who's that?
Here. I'll write it down for you. I'll also leave you with my phone number, just in case you want to spend some more time together. I hope to see you again, Mr. Osborne.
Work.
Oh, Mark. I wondered when you even bothered to show up today.
Mr. Baldwin, I'm sorry. I had a late night last night and I...
Mark, stop. I gave you another chance. I wanted you to clean your act up. I really did. But you messed up again, so I have no choice but to let you go.
I...
Mr. Baldwin, please.
I've already had your office packed. I expect you to be out of the building by noon.
I really am sorry, Mark, but I must put the good of the company first. Good day, Mr. Osborne.
Gianna? It's Mark, from last night. I was wondering if you wanted to go get drinks Friday night? Oh, of course. I'll pick you up at 5?
This is Mark Osborne.
What do you want?
Oh, I'm here to see Mr. Tony Robustelli. Hello?
Come in quickly.
Please have a seat. So, you sought me out. I'm guessing you're here for one of my services.
Yes, I was told to come to you for help.
Yeah, by who?
Giada, young Cardinal.
Oh yeah, beautiful woman. How'd you two meet?
I was at a bar.
That's enough. Like I said, she's a socialite. Loves the nightlife.
Yeah, she told me.
Yeah, of course she did. Now, to business, and I'm guessing by your tired appearance and your overall presentation that I'm gonna guess you're here for the money.
Money? Wait a minute, is this a loan shark setup?
Mark, you flatter me. See, the difference between myself and other people is that I don't expect to get the money back. I give you money, and that's it. Let me elaborate. I will hand over a bank account to you. Spend it however you want. And at a predetermined time, I will request the account back. Whatever you want to do, there's no fine print, it's up to you. How's that sound?
Alright.
Okay.
Alright.
All you gotta do is sign here and it's all yours.
Right.
A little paperwork, keep yourself accountable, and all your financial dreams will come true. Mark, that's a deal.
Hello, how can I help you?
I'm here to see Mr. Baldwin.
Are you Mr. Blackwell?
Yes.
Okay, he's in his office.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Mark. I know you go by Mr. Blackwell now.
Shut up, Brian.
Hey now, what was all that about?
Well, how would you react if your friend fired you in your lifetime of need?
Listen, Mark, I did what was best for the company.
No matter. I'm not mad at you, I actually came here to thank you.
Thank me?
As hard as it is to believe.
I'm not sure I understand.
You see, when you fired me, I had nothing. No job meant no money, and no money meant, I wouldn't be able to pay for anything. My house, food, clothing. But when you fired me, I got desperate, and I made a decision that left me with all the money I could ever ask for.
I understand, Mark. Well, it was good to see you.
Mr. Baldwin?
As you can see, I have a lot of business to tend to.
Of course you do.
Oh, to see without my eyes. The first time that you kissed me, boundless by the time I cried. I built your walls around me. White noise, what an awful sound. Fumbling by Rogue River.
Robustella gave you a bank account and you used it?
Yes, how did you know about that?
That doesn't matter. What does matter is you're in deep legal trouble because the bank account you had belonged to another man and he was very powerful.
You mean the bank account was stolen?
Of course the bank account was stolen, Mark. Who do you think Robustelli is? He's a con man. Steals from others and lets other people take the fall. You're one of the fall guys. One of the suckers.
So, how much trouble am I in? Am I going to prison?
Once the owner of the account is notified, yeah.
Wait, so whose account was it anyway?
I'm surprised you hadn't figured it out already. It's your old boss, Mark. It's Brian Baldwin.
Hold on a second. How do you know all of these things about Mr. Robustelli? How do you know whose account got stolen? Wait. You set this whole thing up!
Now hold on, Mark.
Shut up! I don't want your apologies! I lost everything I had. My friends, my job, my family. All because I thought that you cared. I don't have anything. I'm nothing.
Stop. I had no choice.
No, you stop. You know what? Just stop the damn car. I want out.
Mark.
Now.
Whatever you're doing, be safe.